For much of the day, the tankers here at the Jeffco Tanker Base have been loaded with fuel and retardant and ready to fly. But we're told that the conditions around the fire simply are too dangerous for these planes to go up.
There's lots of potential for fire.
Tanker pilot Dean Talley has been flying air attacks on fires for 34 years.
You have the beetle kill in the forest. You have lots of dry, tinderbox type conditions. When you start losing structures, everybody pays attention.
It's frightening.
But many who come each day to see these vintage 1960s submarine hunter planes, well, they wonder if Washington leaders are paying attention.
Come on, we're out west here. You know what we need. Everybody who lives here knows what we need. Why don't we get it done?
By midday, the planes were still on the ground here at the Jeffco Tanker Base. These trucks that you see are hauling retardant from Idaho. They are bringing about 36,000 gallons of that retardant right here to the base. It's going into tanks right below us.
This is a close-up of the concentrated gook that replaced slurry several decades ago.
It adheres to the material that it is dropped on, and it dries and maintains its ability to retard for several hours.
Choppers drop water to suppress flames. Tankers big and small drop retardant to give crews on the ground a way to the fire line.
A slurry is a substance that was a mixture of dirt and water and sometimes even concrete that was dropped on fires decades and decades ago.
Now the red sticky retardant is used by planes based here.
By 3 o'clock this afternoon, weather conditions over the fire had improved enough to allow two of the small tankers to fly, making this the shortest day of flying for pilots here. At the Jeffco Airport, John Bowman, Fox 31 Denver.